MedCram.com.
Welcome to another MedCram COVID-19 update. We're going to talk about the FDA recommendations to the CDC on booster vaccines for COVID-19 and mixing and matching. And of course, we'll put a link in the description below to this news release. So at the time of this writing, these are the FDA recommendations, which will then go to the CDC and then have to be signed off by the CDC director. So the three vaccines are Pfizer, BioNTech, Moderna, and finally the Johnson & Johnson. And as you may recall, the Pfizer-BioNTech vaccine is given as a first dose, followed by 3 weeks, and then there is a second dose. The Moderna is given as a first dose, and then it's about 4 weeks, and then the second dose is given. And then finally, the Johnson & Johnson vaccine is given once. So what the FDA is saying currently is for those people that had the Pfizer-BioNTech, they can get a booster 6 months after their second dose, and they have to be either 65 years of age plus or 18 to 64 years of age and at high risk, so they have a comorbidity, or they are frequently exposed. So that would be like a healthcare provider, somebody working in an environment where they're exposed often to COVID-19 or SARS-CoV-2 positivity. In terms of Moderna, they have exactly the same criteria. So 6 months, and you have to be either 65 years of age plus or 18 to 64 and high risk or frequent exposure, like a healthcare worker, etc. For those that took the Johnson & Johnson, you only need to wait 2 months after your single shot of the Johnson & Johnson. And there, all you need to be is just 18 years plus. There is no qualification of 65 years of age or high risk or anything else. In other words, they're looking at you to get a second dose or a booster after the first Johnson & Johnson. Now, in terms of what it is that you can actually get, you can get as a booster any one of the three vaccines. So you can get the Pfizer for a booster if you had the Pfizer. You can get the Pfizer vaccine if you got Moderna. Or you can get the Pfizer vaccine if you got the J&J. Also, you could get what is known as the half-dose Moderna, which is the booster shot, if you got the Pfizer, the Moderna, or the Johnson & Johnson vaccine. And also, you can get the Johnson & Johnson as a booster if you got Pfizer before, the Johnson & Johnson booster if you got Moderna before, and of course, you can get the Johnson & Johnson if you got the Johnson & Johnson before. So just to quickly clarify here, this is the FDA recommendations that are going to the CDC and could be signed off by the CDC director in the next few days. This is a news press release on October 20th. And again, Pfizer-BioNTech, 6 months after the second dose, if you are either 65 years of age plus or 18 to 64 and a high-risk group or frequently exposed, you can either get the Pfizer-BioNTech vaccine, a half Moderna dose, or the Johnson & Johnson vaccine. If you had the Moderna and it's been 6 months since your last dose and you're 65 years of age or older, you can go ahead and get it. Or if you're 18 to 64 and high risk or have frequent exposure, you can get the Pfizer-BioNTech, the half-dose Moderna, or the Johnson & Johnson booster. If you had Johnson & Johnson and it's been more than 2 months, you just have to be 18 years of age or older, and you can get the Pfizer, the half-dose Moderna, or the Johnson & Johnson vaccine as your booster. And so in terms of analysis here, notice that there are age limits or there's age cutoffs here for the boosters for these vaccines that already had a second shot. There isn't one really for the Johnson & Johnson. So what they're saying to those that receive the Johnson & Johnson vaccine is go out and get any one of the authorized or approved vaccines if it's been more than 2 months and you're more than 18 years of age. So I hope this clarifies for you whether or not you qualify to get a booster. And I hope you share this with as many people as possible so they are also clear as well. Thanks for joining us and follow us at MedCram.com.